Balikan po natin yung sinasabi ko. Bakit po napakahalaga po ng Pilipinas sa mga globalista? At sabi ho rito, suppose China does not democratize but to continue to grow in economic and military power, a greater China may be emerging whatever the desires and calculations of its neighbors, and on any effort to prevent that from happening could entail an intensifying conflict with China. To accept China as a regional power is not a matter of simply endorsing a mere slogan. There will have to be substance to any such regional preeminence. To put it very directly, how large a Chinese sphere of influence and where should America be prepared to accept as part of a policy of successfully co-opting China into world affairs? What areas now outside of China's political radius might have to be considered to the realm of the re-emerging celestial empire? In brief, U.S. management of its relationship with China will inevitably have direct consequences for the stability of the American-Japanese-Korean triangle security relationship. At hindi lamang po yan. Talagang gigil na gigil itong mga globalista sa China dahil halos lahat po ng bansa ay nasoptas na po ng China. At sabi ho rito, the Philippines has historically been America's key military base, listening post, and naval port in the Far East region. The South China Sea is the world's second busiest international sea lane. More than half of the world's supertanker traffic passes through the region's waters. It is a major choke point, as vital to the world economy as the Panama Canal or the Suez Canal. The United States continues to patrol these seaways. In fact, as Michael Clare points out in his book, Resource Wars, the U.S. is obliged by treaty to ensure the security of Japan, and this in turn entails an obligation to protect Japan. And Japan's vital supply routes, American warships also transverse the South China Sea when sailing between U.S. bases in Japan and the Persian Gulf area. At hindi sinama rito ay yung main operation ng U.S. and Britain dun sa Diego Garcia. Nearly all Asia's energy imported from the Middle East and Africa pass through the Strait of Malacca and through the South China Sea. The bulk of the world's liquefied natural gas passes through the South China Sea too. Tama? A South China Sea that is managed by the U.S. and its allies is vital in the proposed transportation of still unrequited Central Asian oil and gas from its source to its ultimate markets. The demand for oil and energy in developing Asia, particularly China, will grow rapidly in the coming years. It is happening now, di ba? The South China Sea is rich in oil and gas. The Philippines themselves contains a wealth of oil, natural gas, and land. The region has become the focus of intense oil and gas exploration by multinational energy companies, and this could be the next flashpoint. Tama siya. The South China Sea is the gateway to the renowned Golden Triangle, one of the world's key heroin producing regions on Earth. Kaya sabi nga ho ng aking kaibigan, ay hindi lang po gold, oil, and deuterium ang pinaglalabanan, kundi po drugs kasama na. Labanan po ng drug cartel to. Since 2000, when the Taliban destroyed much of the opium crop, sabi dito, that supplied approximately 75% of the world's heroin. Kaya di ba yung mga namamatay ho, ginagamitan po ng opium? Yan po ang pinanggagalingan. Yung area na yan ng Afghanistan na ngayon po ay kinokontrol na po ngayon ng British at ng Amerika rin. Ang lalim. Pero actually hindi na malalim dahil marami nakakaalam na ito eh. At sabi dito, the Golden Triangle has supplanted the Golden Crescent as the number one opium source. The Philippines is both a key drug transit point and an internationally renowned money laundromat. Nakita nyo? Kaya nga ho, ilang beses na ho nasabi na ang ating bansa ay part ng main money laundering operation sa Asia. At dati basa natin ang transit point lamang, pero ngayon po ay tayo po ay manufacturer na rin po ng mga droga na yan. Hindi ba? Kaya nga marami nga nahuhuli ang PIDEA ng mga Shabu Laboratories at mga gawaan mismo. Ito pa, Southeast Asia is a key developing economic region. Leading multinational corporations and investors have vital long-term interests in the region, including oil and gas. Again, Asia will attract increasing interest as many Asian economies have adopted the structural reforms, deregulation, ayan, nayari tayo dito, and privatization, ayan, formulas pushed by the IMF and the World Bank. Following the Asian economic crisis of the late 1990s, the many authorities believe was an orchestrated financial conspiracy. Totoo naman, Asia will become even more attractive as a haven for outside investment if Western markets and economies continue to deteriorate. The Philippines is home to Islamic separatists and guerrilla groups that can be exploited. Ayan! Na-exploit na nga! Manipulated! And at least partially controlled by the CIA just like the Abu Sayyafs. Need I say more? And other intelligence agencies and propagandized as terrorists due to historical ties to the CIA-sponsored Al-Qaeda. And or otherwise targeted for destruction for nationalistic tendencies. Where U.S. interests require force, violent intervention, terrorism is utilized. The fact that some of those or these guerrilla groups are also drug traffickers, just like the Abu Sayyaf, kita nyo, sabi ko sa inyo, marami dyan ay Abu Shabu, fits the pattern of accommodation that is mirrored in other 9-11 war spots like in Central Asia, Latin America, Balkans, Yemen, etc. The Philippines leadership remains deeply connected to Washington and global financial oligarchs. Totoo ho ito. The neo-colonies ties to corporate elites and the members of the current and the former U.S. administrations are historical, persistent, and well-documented. Essentially, the Philippine government continues to function as a U.S. proxy in Asia. That was the reason GMA was granted the position as coordinator by Mother America through Obama. The role of the Philippines takes an on even greater significance when viewed in the context of the larger 9/11 war agenda, which includes, among others, control of key natural resource regions and transit routes, seizure, consolidation, and control of final supplies and deposits of non-renewable world energy supplies, control of international drug traffic, and management of covert narco money flows through world financial system. Wow, lahat pala ng great operation, ginagawa na pala rito. JEA economics, meaning neoliberal corporate globalization. Oo nga, no? Geostrategic positioning in defense of and or expansion of Western security interests, meaning the superpower hegemony. Next, legitimization of the neo-fascism, removal of anti-Western imperialist, anti-globalization, political opposition groups, and nationalist movements. Ongoing manipulation of terrorist groups like Baya intelligence apparatus of the CIA, the Pakistani ISI, and other affiliated proxies to carry out imperial covert agendas, and the war industrial complex, corruption, fraud, and government corporate crime that can be used for blackmail. Ayun, sinasabi ko sa inyo, nakita niyo na? For a multitude of reasons, new as well as time-honored, the U.S. is in the Philippines to stay. Yun ang maliwanag. Thank you, brother, for this very vital information na dapat talagang maintindihan ng aking mga listeners.